Hello, in today's video I'm going to show you how to make this coat hanger. This was a project that we did in a trade school as kids. They would give you a bunch of dull files and hacksaw and go and cut this. It was very time consuming and labor intense, but you cannot give to a 14 year old kid angle grinder because there would be more fingers on the floor than on the hand. So we did this by filing and hacksawing it through. It was nightmare. And a good thing about this coat hanger is that it's forever, just like diamonds. It's going to outlive you and your children probably. It's very strong. Stronger than what it should be for the intended purpose, but hey, you can hang other things on it. So let's see how it's made. So first, for this project you will need 175 millimeters long piece of bar steel that is 60 millimeters wide. 5 millimeters was a thickness of it. It was just a mild steel. So, I recommend you to use the whole bar as it is, mark the lines and then cut it off. Here is blueprint for some of you, this will be enough. For all of you that are not as technically literate, I'm sorry, but I don't know other word to say it. I'm going to go step by step how to do it, so don't worry. So first, what you need to do is divide your steel bar in half. Mark the line with the scribe, center line. Okay, let's zoom in a little bit. So, center line like this. Then, 90 degrees from this line, mark another line that will be 50 millimeters wide. Once you have done that, then mark from end of this line 5 millimeters from one end and the other end. Mark the middle 2.5 millimeters. That's gonna be your radius. This part over here. After you have done that, scribe a line 40 millimeters away from our main line. And add 6 millimeters from each side here and here and draw this line like that. Okay, after that make another line that is 60 millimeters from our main line. That's gonna be line for the holes. And these holes are 6 millimeters away on each end. 5 millimeters hole, through hole as you can see, and then countersink it with 10 millimeter drill bit. These are two holes. Third one will be 18 millimeters from this line that we scribed in the center, of course. So after we have done that, from our main line that is here, this is also gonna be a bend line. Add another line that is 50 millimeters from it, and this is going to be bend line. Come on, focus. Okay, so it's gonna be this line over here. You can see the jaw marks from the vise. From that line, add another bend line that is 60 millimeters. That's gonna be this bend over here. So another line, okay. After that, add another 15 millimeters. And this is not gonna be bend line. This line will be here. You can see the dot So this line will be from here to the bend line. On the middle of it, punch a mark, use a compass to scribe a half circle like this. From this, this line is 5 millimeters on the each side, and make a radius like this. So now we have scribed our coat hanger on the steel. Also, if you don't have layout fluid, you can use a Sharpie or you can use a spray paint. So, unfortunately, I don't remember the correct order of bending. So, before you do this, I recommend you to make a cardboard mock-up, test it in your vise, and see which operation goes first. For this bend over here, I remember that we used the 3/4 water pipe. You can see here we have this line, and this was jaw lines. So what you do, you clamp this piece of steel, our future coat hanger, in the jaws like this. Come on, focus. Oh my god. Okay. Like that. And then this will be straight, of course, this tail, let's call it tail. It's gonna be straight like this. Then clamp 3/4 water pipe inner diameter to this piece of steel with the clamp, like that. And then hit it, don't hit the tip, always hit this end here, and just slowly, slowly, slowly bend it with the hammer, two sides, and that's it. This, I think this one was bent under 45 degrees angle, same as this one. This blueprint doesn't call for angle, all it says that this side here should be, this should be 40 millimeters apart. I think it is 45 millimeters bent. You guys that do bending a lot will know better. This part here should be parallel with this one. So I guess that would be it for today's video. Thank you for watching, and until next time, goodbye.